Good evening. Thank you so much for joining us, those of you who are here in person as well as many more online. I am particularly delighted to have my good friends and colleagues, Jennifer and Matthew Mazzoni, to perform here on our concert series at Second Presbyterian Church. Jennifer and Matt have been making music together for over 15 years after meeting in a theory entrance exam in 2003. They have performed on concert stages nationally and internationally and are recent winners of the Artist Presentation Society. Jennifer studied at Webster University and then later completed her master's degree at Indiana University. Along with being a soloist, Jennifer is equally accomplished as an orchestral flutist. She has appeared as principal flute with the St. Louis Philharmonic, the Indiana University Philharmonic, the Webster Symphony, and the St. Louis Symphony Orchestra, to name a few. She has also appeared with the Bach Society of St. Louis and the St. Louis Symphony Orchestra. In her spare time, Jennifer also homeschools her three children and is quite busy as a mom. In her, Matt studied piano at the University of Michigan in Ann Arbor and later completed his graduate work at Indiana University. Matt is adept both as a soloist and collaborative player, and he has performed with every orchestral instrument under the sun and has appeared in hundreds of programs across the country. Matt is also a church musician, and this led him to St. Louis, where he was the director of liturgical music for Mary, Queen of Peace, in Webster Groves. Matt is currently the director of music ministry at our sister church, Central Presbyterian EPC, in Clayton, Missouri. Following our program, the Mazzonis will be in the connector to greet you. However, we of course must be cautious about maintaining proper social distancing, so what I would ask that you would be mindful of that. Jennifer and Matt have a couple of CDs that they have recorded, and Ginny has graciously displayed them on a table there in the connector if they would be of any interest to you. Before we begin our evening of music, I think we should open with prayer. Our Father, this evening we come together to enjoy your gift of music. We thank you that we can join in person and virtually also during this challenging time. We each come together with joys and sorrows in our hearts, but we also come knowing that you will meet us. As your word says in Zephaniah 3:17, quote, "The Lord your God is in your midst, a mighty one who will save. He will rejoice over you with gladness. He will quiet you by his love. He will exult over you with loud singing." Father, what a great thought it is to comprehend that you not only love us, but that you even sing over us as well. And so we thank you that you are singing over us right now and that we can come together and enjoy the wonderful gift of music that you have given to us, his people. We also give thanks for Jennifer and Matt for their trip here to Memphis, for the gifts that you have given to them, how they have developed them over the years, and even how they have prepared specifically for our program this evening. We pray that you would fill them with great joy and freedom as they minister to us through their music. We pray all of this in Jesus' name, amen. Ladies and gentlemen, would you please welcome Jennifer and Matthew Mazzoni.
Thank you. Thank you so much. It is a delight for us to be here tonight. Matt and I were thinking about the last live concert that we played, and it was actually on March 12th, 2020. And so I think it's kind of appropriate that we are here again in front of an audience, which is just lovely. And thank you for watching at home on live stream. We're just very grateful to be here. This concert tonight is entitled Seasons of Faithfulness. I want to explain why we chose that and a little bit more about just the program tonight. So Matt and I have both been inspired by the hymn, Great is Thy Faithfulness. And the line of the second verse, summer and winter, springtime and harvest, sun, moon, and stars in their courses above, join with all nature in manifold witness to thy great faithfulness, mercy, and love. That line has been with us this year through all of the change, through all of the shutdowns, and all of the different things we've had to experience as people, and certainly as a church and as a family. We have three small children. And so we decided to explore the seasons. The first one tonight was summer, and you noticed it was very youthful. For us, I think we feel that summer is a youthful, playful time. We do have three small children running around, so that kind of encouraged that. That was probably written by Mozart at a very young age, and it has just a delightful quality to it. Matt's going to introduce our next season, fall.
So the next pieces we're going to play are by Johannes Brahms. And we often, Jennifer and I often kind of associate his music with the sort of mature quality that you find in autumn. It's very rustic and it's very hearty sort of music, and you can kind of imagine it in a harvest time. The pieces we're playing are all actually stolen from the duo piano repertoire. First we're going to play, that we've arranged for flute and piano, so we're going to play four of the waltzes and then two Hungarian dances. And in both of these, we just want to imagine people celebrating different settings in different ways, but these are songs of celebration.
Thank you.
does sound like a fun way to spend fall. So the next segment brings us to winter. And we chose this Bach Sonata in E minor. That's actually, the third movement of this is actually one of the very first pieces Jennifer and I ever actually played together. And so it always holds a very special memory for us. But we chose this piece because it has a certain stillness and a certain introspection about it. And winter can sort of evoke that mood in us. You see bare trees, and it just sometimes winter can feel like there's a quiet in the season outside, and there can be kind of a quietness and a waiting. Certainly, I think this winter we all experienced waiting in a different way and in a new way. But there's also a warmth within it. And so even though there's sort of a stillness and this kind of quiet contemplation, then there's also this, it can be a very warm, like a warm fire that's drawing you in and giving you hope for what is to come. So this is our Bach Sonata in E minor.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. That's one of our favorite pieces. So I just love it when we get to play that piece. So now we come to the spring portion, and I think it's appropriate. We are almost in the season of spring, so we do have that hope. And I love spring. I love Easter. I love the celebration of rebirth. It's just a wonderful time of year. And so we chose to close the program with the Franck Sonata. And I want to point out, This movement, this piece actually is in four movements, and each movement I feel like reflects a different time of the year. So I thought it was appropriate that we would close the concert with spring, but also with the idea that this sonata actually shows all four seasons. The first season is almost like a summer day. It's languid and it takes a long time to develop. It's just really beautiful. The second is almost like winter. It's stormy. It's a little bit tumultuous at times. The third is just really, I guess that would be autumn. I'm out of order of my seasons, but you get the idea. The third movement is just a beautiful recitative, but the reason we chose this piece was for the last movement, which actually is a celebration. It was actually written, Franck wrote this piece as a wedding gift for a friend, and you can hear almost wedding bells in the end of this piece. And so we just hope that this is an encouragement to you. There's so much hope and joy in this piece, and enjoy the Franck Sonata.
Thank you. Thank you.
well, since we titled it Seasons of Faithfulness, and we were inspired by Great is Thy Faithfulness. We're going to now play for you Great is Thy Faithfulness, and we hope that this will be a balm to your heart tonight, an encouragement to you, however you may be tonight, and in your heart and in your spirit, we pray that you be singing right along with us.
Meeting some of you back out there. All right. Thank you very much.
Thank you.